Hello, friends, and welcome to the Saitama Stacker channel. My name's Dean. The gentleman on the screen you see is Willie D, and we're going to be talking about him and the Saitama Project today. If you just woke up or crawled out from under a rock and you haven't had a chance to see what's going on, I'll get you up to speed here, but I'm pretty late to the game because most of this stuff happened early this morning. I actually woke up to some text messages about people concerned about Saitama, about the Saitama Project, about the price and what was happening. And I will show you that while it was a very disturbing day, honestly, from a price perspective, I don't know what to say other than, to me, it's getting to a point where it's getting personal, okay? We've got people who are out there working hard and doing the best they can, and then you've got people out there who are working as hard as they can to tear down the project. And so I'm going to get into that, and I'll get into it quickly. But I want to show you, I knew in advance, so I looked at some of the metrics earlier today, what was happening with Saitama, that with the heavy descent in the price and then a really high volume, that some big things were going to happen in the fundamentals. And so I will show you what's going on with the fundamentals, and then we'll get right into Willie D and how the team is responding, okay? So let's jump in here. Okay, so I don't have my mouse, so I'm having to use the mouse trackpad here, and it's kicking my butt. All right, today's 11/18. So there are currently 246,659 holders of Saitama. That's an increase of 3,278. Our market cap rank is 54th among all cryptocurrency, according to, based on our market cap and coin market cap. And depending on how this all plays out today, we'll be looking at CoinGecko, okay? I'm not really sure who is responsible for the hit job that did what it did with Saitama today, but we're going to get to the bottom of it. I'm confident of that. So our current market cap is just under $3 billion, down about $300 million from yesterday. Now, had you looked at this at the right point in time, you would have been scared to death, okay? Last night, very late at night, we saw big time dips in the Saitama market cap and price. And I'll show you what that chart looks like. And we can kind of talk about it. So this 24-hour time range should put that right in for us. Okay. So everything's plodding along just fine around 7.08. And all of a sudden it takes a massive drop. To 7046. Some people's charts actually goes deeper than that, but then there's some recovery and then some dip and some recovery, and ultimately we've recovered right back to around the 707. So compared to yesterday, if a person had fallen asleep and just woke up, you probably would just think, oh, we're down and it's a down day, and the market in general looks down. I mean, all of the top cryptocurrencies are down pretty big today. It's what we would consider a red day. The ones that aren't down are basically the stable coins. Okay, so look at what's going on here, you guys. For the 24-hour, for the 7-day, in almost every single category we're down. Here's Avalanche with the 7-day up, but these are the top, here we are, the top 30, all the way down the list, you guys. It's just been a tough week. So Saitama is actually not too far off what's going on with the rest of the market in terms of its performance this week. But there was that moment, and I'll show you what caused that moment here in just a second, okay? I want to jump back into this, though, because it is quite fascinating. With a declining price and an increase in volume, it's the burn is going to increase, and so are the reflections, okay? So volume in the last 24 hours, 200 and almost 20 million. So look what happens to the burn. Okay, yesterday we were at 55.81, 55.85%. Okay, so a pretty big tick up. The burn speedometer would say if we could maintain that pace of market cap and volume, we would burn almost 24% per year, 1% every 15 days, and 34 trillion tokens burned in this event. Okay, so those are positives, but the way they came about was really not positive. It was quite the opposite. So let me just jump in and show you what is going on here. Okay, so CoinMarketCap, right on the Saitama, if you went to check price on Saitama, they posted, or somebody posted, it's unclear to me if this was a paid for advertisement, that's one of the rumors, or if CoinMarketCap felt like they needed to disclose this, but it says Willie D, a partner of Saitama, to clarify that, he is a contracted influencer. He made a contract with Saitama to work on the NFT side and to get other influencers, big name music people, anybody really, to work with Saitama on NFTs. Says he was sentenced in a wire fraud scam, and then it shows FBI. For more information on the partnership, visit here, which is linked to our site, and the FBI press release, visit here. Okay, so you go in there is an FBI press release from 2010. So when I said yesterday, I think all of the major things that I wanted to get some clarity on with Russell coming forward and addressing the situation that he did yesterday, that I knew this had happened. I was in streams and people were talking about it. People have talked about it since the Cytomask launch party. But when I actually went out and looked at it, I kind of thought, well, yeah, it was 11 years ago. And I'm not being dismissive of the behavior. I mean, he Willie D ended up doing some time over this deal, it would appear. Okay. But it's 11 years ago. And I'm thinking, how is this relevant to today? Okay. He's not in charge of the reins. We're not dealing with financial transactions with him that aren't verifiable with the team of what he's contracted to do from a work perspective. So why did this have to be posted on CoinMarketCap? I don't know. The team's going to get to the bottom of that, okay? If you go to Russell's Twitter page, or really any of the Twitter pages for that matter, the development team is saying that they are meeting tomorrow with attorneys, and they're going to try to get to the bottom of this whole thing. And, you know, I mean, it really did. At one point, it tanked the price out by, you know, 60%, 70% overnight. It's pretty darn crazy. Got a ghost behind me. I thought maybe one of my dogs. So here is that announcement. We will not sleep till this matter is handled swiftly and appropriately. The Saitama dev team is going to meet tomorrow, and they will do their AMA afterwards to let us know what's going on, 4 p.m. Central. Okay, so that will be informative, I'm sure. We'll get some clarity, and I'm glad that they're addressing it. Now, I want to talk a little more about Willie D. Okay, Willie D is a musician. Willie D, back in his time, was one of the top musicians, and I'm sure he's still very skilled. Okay, but he came up in what guys my age who graduated in the 90s would kind of think of like the gangster rap scene. As a matter of fact, one of his most popular songs that you can almost have not heard if you've watched any movies is the lyric is, "Damn, it feels good to be a gangster," you know? And so I think it went through some hard stuff. I mean, you would kind of expect in that scene, you'd be exposed to a lot of things. And I don't know his whole backstory, and I'm not going to try to even guess. But when they made him an influencer, I decided to follow his channel. Okay, so this is Willie D. This is his channel. Willie D posted this video 5 hours ago. There are 39,000 views. He has 683,000 subscribers. Okay, I think he's come a long way from 10 years ago to now. He's talking about difficult topics. I've watched several of his videos. I could flip back and show you how many red bars there are. I think he does take on some controversial topics. But his tone that I see is him trying to tell the community, and a lot of times addressing the black community, that, you know, this lifestyle doesn't work, you guys. So you look at what these comments are from his viewers, and they're saying, I wish every big name in the hood would spread the same message, all love and respect with you. Well said, brother. We have to go to war on all things and people that don't free us, keep us safe. I don't say this often, but I love this man. You're a real one, Will. As an educator, it hurts me to admit this. Willie, you are right. I'm trying to save every student I come into contact with, but I'm just not able to all of the time. Okay? His messages in these videos are messages of change, messages of hope. And, you know, from what I've seen for the most part, trying to encourage people to take the high road. Well, where does he come from that position on? You know, he comes from coming up out of the gangster rap scene. And I'm sure he's seen a lot of hard things in his life. So I give him credit for making change, for still being relevant and highly esteemed within the community that he came out of. So I can see why somebody with this type of influence would be attractive to different people. It's not just Willie D we partnered with. They partnered with the professor, who's a basketball YouTube influencer with lots of people. Okay, they've made partnerships all over the place. And so just, I think, take it for what it's worth. But it's getting old, you know, the hit jobs and the just the total negativity when we're trying to do something revolutionary and for the good. Now, I said it yesterday, but the development team, pretty much everything they've said, they've come through with. Okay, so I want to see the Cida Mask launch and how that plays out. I want to see how we come through this, what our NFT creator looks like, the buying portals that are coming online with the Cida Mask at some point. So I'm willing to wait and see this play out. Okay, I'll show you my reflections at the end of the video. And guys, it's crazy what happened because of this dip. And I feel bad. I'm sure a lot of people panicked and sold. I don't know how I would have felt if I had been watching it in real time. Probably, fortunately, I was asleep. Come here, Petey. Come here. Come here, buddy. Come here. This is Petey. Come here, bud. Stand up here. You see him? Can you say hi? Yeah? This is my dog, Petey. He's one of three, and he must be missing me because he keeps checking in on me. All right, bud. Okay. I'll be out in a minute, okay? Go play. Go play. All right. Petey. He's a good guy. I'm ready. I'm willing to let this play out. I think some people managed to buy in amazing prices who bought this dip. I didn't buy any extra, but I do have a lot more tokens than I had yesterday. But before I get to that, I want to show you one more thing, okay? There's a member in the Wolfpack community who has been working pretty much every single night for several weeks now, over a month. And he streams with Cuffin' the Dip. His name is Justin, but his page is JustAman04. And he's getting close to 1,000 subscribers, okay? Now, getting 1,000 subscribers isn't a goal that people set that do YouTube content because it feels good to achieve the goal. But it's the point in your journey where you can actually be monetized with YouTube and get paid for the advertisements that they put on your videos. And so I want to give Justin some help and just tell you guys, hey, if you're checking in, if you're watching Cuffin' the Dip, they're both streaming at the same time, you know, give the guy a subscribe and let's get him up to 1,000 so he can continue to bring content forward and support the community. Justin, I wish you the very best of luck. I catch your show as often as I can. I appreciate the work you guys are doing. And the show is getting better and better, by the way. All right, reflections, folks. So, pretty nuts what's going on. Now, when the price goes down and the volume goes up, the amount of tokens it buys is crazy. My reflections, the last 24 hours, 711 million, okay? Almost 3/4 of a billion Saitama tokens in one day. That by far is the most I've ever received. I don't think I had a day over 500. There's one right there, 549 million. Okay. But that's crazy. Now, would I rather have a large bag of reflections in the day or an ascending price? I would take the ascending price at any time. But at least in spite of the down days, we're still have something positive that comes out of it. So Wolfpack, you got to do you. You got to make what decisions are right for you, whether you stay or you go. I respect you either way. But I think that once the Cytomask launches and people are able to see it and get their hands on it and see what impact it can make in the ease of trading in crypto and other positive things that will be a part of it, that we're going to be the trendsetters. Okay, we have been up to this point. You have one misstep followed with just brutal attacks. And some of the attacks, to be fair, I mean, everything that has been attacked has an element of truth to it, okay? But is it really relevant now? For me, first, I mean, with Willie D especially, man, I'm willing to give the guy a second chance. Good heavens, man, it's been 10, 11 years. And when I looked at it, which I did, it's out there. Yes, it sounded like it wasn't appropriate activity, but I mean, there's worse things, you know, and I'm not trying to make excuses for anybody. I'm just saying that's not the person who I'm seeing today. I'm seeing somebody who's leading in his community, who's creating content to try to make a difference and encourage people to be better and rise above. So, Willie, if you ever want to go to lunch sometime, hit me up. I'd love to do it. Rest of the Wolfpack, stay strong, folks. We're going to have better days. I can't help but think we're going to have better days. All right. Have a great night and catch up with me tomorrow. We'll watch our Cytomastax grow together.